So my name is Chris Hourigan. We're currently in my office in my lab at the National Heart, Lung, Blood Institute, which is in the National Institutes of Health in Bethesda, Maryland.
So Chris, what do you want to do? Do you want to actually help present a case, or do you want to just talk about
it? So I'm a scientist. I'm also a physician, physician-scientist. And we're looking at, in humans who have a blood cancer, a specific kind of blood cancer called acute myeloid leukemia. And we're really looking at two things. One, can we get better at diagnosing and tracking that disease over time? Can we do more high sensitivity ways to look for that disease? And can we find new ways to treat that disease beyond what's been done previously? I've worked other jobs. Not all jobs are fun. Science is something that's fun for me. Every morning I get up, I'm excited. Sometimes at night I can't go to sleep or wake up in the night thinking about science. You know, looking back, my parents were actually really smart. They always told me you can do whatever you want to do once you finish college. It was never if you go to college. It was always once you finish college. It wasn't until I got to college I actually realized none of my family had been to college before. I was the first member of in my extended family to actually go through college. I spent a summer in the lab and thought, wow, this is great. This is different to school. I really didn't like school, but I loved being in the lab, asking questions, and really looking things up, trying hard, and you actually work things out, rather than memorizing what someone else has done.
It's I for air, I6. I saw the band, but the band is bigger than me. Did you see there are a lot of
bands? Yeah.
I don't know which one. Maybe I can use the IP.
I think a lot of the buzz you get from sports, actually you can get from science. The thing people don't really know about science is it's incredibly exciting. It's addictive. You get the feedback of just finding these incredible things, which is similar to the kind of buzz we used to get when we used to win a game in sports. And so I'd hope in 10 or 15 years' time, there are other things that come with science. You publish papers, you give talks. But really what we'd like is if someone is diagnosed with the disease that we study, in 10 or 15 years' time, their life is going to be better because of work we've done. That's really the only end game for us, is that we improve the outcome for people who have this disease we're studying.
Hey guys, I might want
to work. We talk about, on a small scale, the experiments we're doing at the moment. So the experiments for the day we'll run through, we'll talk about the experiments we're planning for this day, why they're important, the things we're going to look out for, any additional controls or extra piece of information we'd like to get from that experiment. We'll talk about the experiments they've done previously, and we'll go through that data they've generated and try and work out what it means, what we do next, what's the experiment we now need to do to work out what's missing from that picture. And so really we're always building on the previous experiments. There's never a total eureka moment where it all just falls together and there's no more work to do. We're always improving that experiment we did last time with another experiment and getting closer and closer to what we think is the truth. We're really trying to move away from a kind of medicine where it's one size fits all. You have a disease, we put a label on it, and we give you some therapy that works on average for average people, and try and get down to specifically for you, what's the treatment that's going to work for the disease you have and the person you are. And that's really the personalization we're trying to get at. And don't be dispirited by the kind of the classes you've had in high school or the classes you've had in college. The actual doing science is very different to that. I didn't enjoy college. I didn't enjoy my college science classes. But I love the work I do now as a scientist. It's really a great opportunity. It really is an honor and a privilege to come to work every day and try and do something good for humanity, for people. That's great that I can come in and do that. And it's fun. It's incredibly exciting. So I'd say you don't have to be the smartest person in the world. What you do have to do is you have to care and you have to stick at it. If you've got that drive, I think it's possible to have a very fulfilling time in science.